Lord. Jesus, hallelujah. Glory to God. The Savior's name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Power in that name. Healing in that name. Salvation in that name. No other name given amongst men whereby we might be saved. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Hey, my little mercy. The name of Jesus. There's no name on under the heaven given unto me. No other name. No other name whereby men must be saved but by that name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Anybody in here bold enough to say that name? Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. You got enough faith to say that name.
Testifying, but I didn't tell about the bad things.
you know, people were saying, they used to come out and say it was drugs, but immoral things that I did before God came into my, before God led me to my aunt's house, and was not saved, and I wasn't saved. And it was a lady there that was a member of this church that had the Bible open and shared the Lord Jesus with. And we both got saved. So God is still working miracles, leading and guiding his people. But if you're in any kind of pain or any kind of problem that you're going through and you don't know the answer, you don't know how this is going to turn out, just look around and raise those hands up again. These people that God has worked miracles, he's worked miracles in our lives. And if you need somebody, look around you and you might get a chance to talk to them. What did he? We should let us share with one another what God has did. Because he brought me out of a lot of ugly things. I mean, they were ugly and I was on my way to hell. I was brought up in the church. But when I graduated from high school, I thought I was growing up, you know. Hey, I could do what I wanted to. But we have a Lord and a Savior and someone that we're going to be before the throne of judgment. So if you're having any kind of situation, any kind of pain or problem, look around you and let's look around and share with others our testimony, because God is able to save. He's able to heal. He's able to give you peace. If you don't have peace, he's able to give you joy. If you don't have joy, he's able to do everything except fail. So Jesus is the answer. So I just wanted to just obey God that if you're in, you don't know what to do, or look to some of these that's been walking with the Lord, and he will lead you all the way through. So God bless you. I love you. I thank God for our pastor and these teachers and leaders, these examples to help us along.
Amen.
Praise God. I give all glory to God and honor. He's my miracle worker.
Yes.
He's my healer. He's my protector.
I am praying, and every time I come, I do get rain, but
I love Jesus.
Yes.
And I want to go to church, love him, regardless of what you're going through. Because he'll bring you through it.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Dear Lord, to God.
Yes,
come at a different aspect this morning. Everybody seen the news this week, right?
That's right.
Sister Brianna, Sister Dorothy, I thought about y'all. I know y'all got people on the East Coast. Y'all know what they're going through this morning.
Yes.
So
right.
You can't praise the Lord right now. And you got to praise the Lord. I spend probably 20 hours a day working, every day, trying to make it happen.
Yes.
But it realized to me, I can't spend that much time working all the time. Because if something like that happened, you can't replace that. You can't replace these people's lives. The insurance can't replace these people's lives.
That's right.
They can never go back to where they come from. Let's not wait until something like that happened to us before we realize who is our master.
This is a testimony slash thank you. Let me just start, and I want to tell you all the good, the bad, and the ugly. Is that all right, Sister Hill? Let me start by saying this. All of my utilities were past due. Every one. I just didn't have the money to pay them. But I continue to trust God. My electricity went off. Let me go back a minute. About 2 weeks ago, I got a phone call from a gentleman, and he asked me, could he rent one of my bedrooms? Saints, before I even thought, I even prayed, all I could think of was, here's help. Here's help. Everything was past due. The electricity was off. Here's help. But I backed up and I said to him, let me apologize to you. I didn't think, I didn't even pray. Let me back up. I'm coming at you like I'm desperate, and I'm not desperate. God is going to take me through this. Tuesday night, we had a women's meeting, and let me do a sidetrack here and tell you how it was wonderful. It was wonderful. Sister Hill, I did have a little sense. When I told that man yes, it backed up. It's like I stopped thinking. I knew the no was there to fly. I couldn't seem to get that. So I called Sister Hill. I said, I need some advice. She gave me some wonderful advice. She just didn't say, yeah, move him in or no. She just simply gave me advice. She said, don't let your good be evil spoken of. She said, I know you're a godly woman. And as far as your neighbors know, you're a godly woman. But if you move that man in, they're not going to know that that's just business. The thing they think is you shacking up. That's what they're going to jump to. That whole testimony of 7 years of living holy, it's just going to be wiped away. So we talked a while, and she said to me, Sister Dorothy, tonight is our meeting, and I want to bring this need to the ladies. Would you mind? And I said, no, Sister Hill, I have no pride in this. If you have a need, you just have a need. She did that, you all. There were 11 of us. And I'm going to be open here and tell you how much that bill was, Sister Judy. That bill was $250. That's how far behind I was. I want you to know, I had said to God, I said, well, I certainly am not expecting these ladies to pay that bill. But whatever they bless me with, I'm just going to hold on to it. And just as money's come in, I'm just going to put it with it. But I want you to know, they gave me $250. Later that night, about 10 o'clock, I hear this bam, bam, bam on my stomach. I learned this. Well, I've always known it, but I've never had this experience, Alicia, where the devil was in my face. Make a decision. Make it now. Do this. And I backed up. I hold y'all to know what he did. I was talking to somebody, and they said to me, they were talking about the guy who called me. They said, he's looking, watching to see what you're going to do. And then he said, but God is watching to see what you're going to do. Yeah. And he said, anytime you're getting ready to have a breakthrough, God, the devil will send counterfeit. If I had taken this on myself and made this little stupid decision, I would have got some money. I would have got something paid. Sister Deborah, God paid everything. And then, y'all have been putting in applications and applications and applications. But I want y'all to know, Sister Dorothy got a little job. I work for AARP. AARP sent me to youth services. I'm so excited. I'm working with teenagers. And guess what they got me doing, y'all?